Born ready, right? Aki Kareem, British Boxing Television. I'm happy to be joined by Raza Hamza. And Raza, it's been a while since we caught, man. It's good to see you.
Good to see you too, Aki.
Fresh trim going on there as well.
Oh, fresh trim, bro. I've just like come out of the shower.
Yeah. is this your natural look, is it? Yeah.
Natural look, bro.
So you just said to me there before we recorded that you've been doing a bit of training, been doing a bit of mixing up, a bit of weights, a bit of everything like that.
Yeah, before Ramadan, I was doing some pad work and stuff, but because of Ramadan, my mate who was doing the pads is locked off, so I'm doing bits of weights, bits of running and stuff, just trying to keep busy a few times a week.
Yeah. How are you finding training during lockdown? And, you know, are you finding inventive ways to keep yourself ticking over and keep yourself fit?
At first, when lockdown come along, my fight had been cancelled, so I was kind of glad I had a bit of a break, but now I'm just sick of it. I really want to crack on now and just get in the ring, get in training, and really want to move forward. But other than that, I'm just doing whatever we can. And I mean, I've got access to a gym now, so I've got my own key, so I'm going whenever I really and train.
Well, it looks like some people are starting to like cleanse the gym properly, get the guys in to do the fuming, and it looks like some pros are starting to go back and stuff into the gym. But it does help having your own key and training yourself, doesn't it? Your own facility.
Yeah, absolutely. I'm very fortunate to have a few friends around me who have let me use their own gym. So I'll go in, do some weightlifting, do some running. But I mean, how much weightlifting and running can you do?
So, yeah.
Just want to crack on, really.
You might end up a middleweight if you keep doing all them weights.
10.5 stone now, fight a featherweight, 9 stone.
Yeah. I see the pictures, man. You're looking a bit tanky, aren't you?
Yeah, I've put some size on, man.
Yeah, man. Well, am I right in thinking you've actually moved back to Manchester then, or you're moving back to Manchester? What's the plan, man? I've heard some things that you're coming back to the homeland.
I'm originally from Birmingham. All my family's from Birmingham. However, I did make the move to Manchester a few years ago, trained there with Haroon. Then my younger brother passed away and I had to move back to home to be around my dad. He was alone. I trained with Max McCracken and the Yafais, so I was in very good company for 18 months. And now everything's kind of calmed down. I believe for me to achieve my best and to get the best of my abilities, I have to be away from home training. So I'm moving back to Manchester.
Yeah. You touched on something there, Raza, and I hope you don't mind. Just only speak about what you want to speak about, but obviously you had the very sad news about your brother, and I was really genuinely gutted to hear that. You know, was there any point where you just thought about walking away from boxing, or has it something that solidified you in your training more? I don't know.
For the last 18 months, I didn't want to box anymore. I'm not in love. I wasn't in love with boxing anymore because I believed after my brother died, I had my best performance, you know, and then when I moved back home, things kind of went downhill for me. I didn't want no more. Until 4 weeks ago, I wanted to walk away from the sport. I didn't want to box. And I've got grateful people around me where I can do other things in my life. I'm not short of opportunities and short of ideas. However, boxing is something my mom wanted me to do, my late mom, my brother, my grandfather. It was their dream, you know, which I made into my ambitions. So it's kept me motivated. And now the news I've had, I'm hungrier than ever. But it was a stage, for a long stage, I didn't want to box anymore.
In some ways, that might have now coming back into it and everything. And it may, as you said, make you more hungry. And down the line, you know, in those really tough spots, it might actually spur you on, maybe.
I mean, I'm different to most fighters because I have a reason to fight. I fight for my mom, for my brother, my father. I don't box for money. You know, if it was for money, I wouldn't be boxing. I fight for a complete different reason. And I have that extra, I believe I have that extra 10% in me when I enter the ring in living of their names, you know. I'm fighting for them, and quitting for me like dying. Losing for me like dying. You know, I can't see myself. How will I ever look at myself if I ever lost? And one day it may happen, it may not, but I just believe this is my destination and this is my life and this is going to be my career.
Mm-hmm. Well, yeah, you did have that spell away, as you said, you mentioned, but you know, you rejoined with your old trainer, Haroon Headley, and you're going to be training in Manchester. Now, you know, was that a sort of like an easy conversation to sort of get back in contact and just say, look, come on, we're ready to go now.
I mean, I've always been good with everybody. When I left Heroon, I had my reasons. Hence, my brother passing, my father being alone, me becoming a man and taking care of what had to be taken care of. What I realized in the last 18 months was there's more to life than boxing. You know, I'm a kid who's always training anyways, but family, once they're gone, they don't return. You know, it's something that never comes back. So, you know, I explained to Haroon, listen, Haroon, I have to go back now, but if I'm ever going to go back to another trainer, it will be you. I promise you that, because, I mean, you've been good to me and I never lost. So, you know, I kept in touch with Haroon, even though I was training with McCracken. And a few things happened, and that's it, man. It was never a question of if Haroon would take me back anyways. It was about when I was ready to go back. And, you know, we've always had a good understanding, so the door was always open for me.
Yeah. Well, I know he's certainly very, very happy to have you back. And are you looking forward to just sort of, because obviously you became part of the Manchester boxing scene when you was over here. Are you looking forward to seeing your old friends again and being part of the gym and the gym mates again and all that sort of side of it?
See, like, people don't understand. Manchester is my second home. And not just my friends. You know, when I'm in Manchester, I'm focused. Here, I have very much distractions. I have distractions. I have a lot of people around me. I'm always one decision away from going to jail, basically. You know, because there's so much shit that goes on where I come from. It's not nice, and a lot of people will tell you that. And therefore, Manchester, I'm focused. I'm dedicated. I'm away from everybody. Monday to Friday, the only people I meet is maybe two or three people, including Haroon. And I'm training. So I'm happy to just be focused 100%. When I know I'm in Manchester, I know I'm there for a reason. And that's it, really. I'm just glad to be back there and focused on what's important in my life and not worried about any other rubbish thing.
No, that's good. That's good, man. I'm glad to hear that you know, it's going to have a lot of positive benefits as well, not just the boxing. You know, your style, I've always liked your style. Flashy, good mover, quite vicious to the body. You know, I've been there live to see you fight a lot. Your last couple of fights, one was in Birmingham, one was in Bolton. So, you know, your next fights, I understand there's some link up with Tunde Ajayi as well going on now. Can you tell us a little bit more about this?
Well, first I'm going to just address a few things. My last three fights, I was under MTK. I had a little injury, which I was out the ring, and I'm a fighter who wants to win every fight by knockout. I have to win every fight, that's how I believe. And my last three performances on points, and I weren't happy with my performances because I believe I am much better than that. So, once again, going back to saying my lack of dedication in Birmingham, maybe, and my sacrifice and my focus wasn't where it needs to be. Then that, I think, is the correct time for me to move away, because I'm ready for anybody. It's not a question of who. I'm asking, like, when. Tell me when. I'm ready for them. And how the Tunde Ajayi move come along, you know, I was on the brink of walking away from boxing. I didn't want to box. I'm 26 and I'm thinking, through this, I don't need it, man. I don't make no money from it. My achievements, what I achieved as an amateur and my talent and everything, it's belittled, you know. Nobody gives a shit. That's how I felt. So, obviously, I had my reasons. I was going to move back to Manchester. Spoke to Haroon. Spoke to Tunde. And listen, man, honestly, it's the best move I could have made. You know, Tunde, I'm really impressed. I've been watching Tunde from day one. I'm really impressed on how he maneuvers his fighters, how he looks after you, how he will do what's best for you. He's not a yes man, you know. I'm really happy to have a great manager in my corner. He's a very good man. You see what he's done with Anthony Yard?
Yeah, absolutely.
From rags, you know.
Absolutely, and he nearly pulled off that spectacular upset as well. You're so close.
And, you know, that's the direction I want to go in. And, you know, with him in my corner and my trainer, we're all on the same page. And that's very important to have everybody being on the same page, everybody knowing where we're going, and we know what we want. I'm sure as a team, we will achieve it.
Yeah, I mean, he's got the right connections. He's got a great energy, positive energy. So that energy will probably rub off onto you as well and all the other fighters.
Absolutely. You know, one thing he tells me is we only focus on us. We don't watch other people. Stay positive, keep working, and the best things will come to you. And, you know, by him saying that, it means a lot to me because I've had downs and lows in my whole life. So things are only going to get better now. Okay, you get it. I'm 26. 2 years ago, it probably would have been too soon for me when things were meant to happen and there were pullouts. I think now is the perfect time, the perfect age, and I'm around the perfect team.
Sounds like you're getting it back, you know, solid as you want it, Raza. Is there anything, have you had any conversations about potentially when you might get out, or is it still very much up in the air now?
Well, you know, as I say, step at a time. In the past, I've learned a lot. I've been a pro for 4 or 5 years. I've learned, take your time. When the time is right, the time is right for you. Don't rush. Now I'm in the hands of Tunde as a manager. I let him get on with it. He just told me, stay busy, stay focused, keep training, and something good will come. And that's it. I leave it with my trainer and my manager. And I think, hopefully, August, man, you know, as soon as boxing returns, man, it won't be long before I'm fighting, definitely.
Well, I'm looking forward to seeing that return to the ring, Raza, and it's really nice to speak to you. I'm glad you're in a good place, looking good, looking ready. And, you know, when you come down to Manchester as well, we'll do this in person.
Absolutely, and I'm very grateful for you interviewing me and giving me the time. But yeah, when I'm back, we'll do a proper one, man.
Definitely, brother. Well, listen, I'll let you get on with your evening. I wish you the very, very best. Is any like little shout outs you want to do before we go? I know boxers always want to do a shout out at the end.
You know, follow my career, follow my progress, follow me on my social media. And once again, thank you to yourself. Thank you to my trainer, Haroon. Thank you to Tunde. And also thank you to Max McCracken for the last 18 months for looking after me, for training me, for making me feel at home and being very understanding to when I had to make the decision. Hence, he knows why I made the decision. Arun knows why. So thank you very much to these people. And sky's the limit, man. I'm coming for it.
Just give us your Instagram handle, man, so people can follow you.
I've got a new Instagram. My other one got deleted. But I deleted it. Raza Hamza 1. Raza, R-A-Z-A, Hamza, H-A-M-Z-A, 1, the number 1. There's only one of me.
There's only one, man. There's only one Raza Hamza. Yeah, guys, get on board with Raza Hamza. He's 14-0 now, and he's going, you know, he's going great guns. Great to talk to you, Raza, and we'll catch up again soon.
Thank you, Aki.
All the best, brother. Take care. See you later.